time now for our holiday brunch, and joining us this morning is a special guest chef, Hilary Phelps. Good morning.
Good morning.
So we have a sweet treat today. Tell us what we're making.
We do. So this is my great-grandmother was of the generation where she never wrote down recipes. Mm-hmm. You know, she had a certain bowl, put flour up to here, sugar to here, mix it all together. And she made everything from scratch. So this is the recipe that we found to be the closest to her homemade shortbread.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
So you had said today on this rainy day you didn't want to haul your mixer in here. Right. So we're going to go through what you theoretically right. would mix up to get this end product here.
Exactly. And it's a great day. You know, it's a great day to hang out at home and mm-hmm. make this recipe and enjoy them during the Ravens game today. So we'll just walk through the steps.
Okay, it looks relatively simple here.
It's so easy, and that's the great thing, and it looks so nice. And you can take them to a housewarming party. Mm-hmm. You can give them as Christmas gifts in this nice container. There's so many things you can do with it. You can eat them in the morning with your coffee.
So, why not?
Exactly. Sweet treat in the morning to get you started. But we start with a cup of sugar.
Okay.
And then 3 sticks of butter, and you cream that in.
Three sticks of butter for one batch.
Yeah.
No wonder they're so
good. It makes a lot. But every once in a while, you know, everything in moderation.
Sure.
But so you cream those together, and you put in a teaspoon of vanilla.
Okay.
And then you sift in. So you have 3.5 cups of flour. You mm-hmm. sift it in your sifter with the salt. This is my grandmother's.
Wow.
So I always feel like she's making
these
goodies with me.
Wow.
They
don't make them like this anymore.
I know. So I treasure that. You mix that all together with the salt. Cream that all together in the mixing bowl.
Okay.
And then we get to the dough.
All right.
And so you want to put the dough in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. And what that does, when you cream the butter, it then solidifies mm-hmm. the dough a little bit, so it's easier to roll out.
Okay.
So we take the dough.
While you're rolling this out here, Hilary, yeah. let me ask you, now that the Olympic mania has died down,
yeah.
what's going on with you these days?
Oh my gosh. So this summer, it's so funny because people say, how was your summer? And we're like, it was fine. And they're like, we saw you. And I'm like, oh yeah, that was London.
Oh, yeah,
like
that.
It seems so. It was great, though. It was a lot of fun, and we're happy to be back. This is hard to roll out.
Well, this has probably been refrigerated a little bit more than half an hour, so maybe we'll cut you
refrigerated overnight, so it's easier to roll out.
You know what? Instead of rolling out, let's try them, because these look delicious.
These are great. And then the great thing, you can get these little cutters, or you can get big ones. So the first time I made them, I didn't have specific cutters, so I used
They're
a big
really
biscuit
good.
Cutter, and so they were these massive shortbread cookies, but they
like
were
biscuits.
Delicious. They were biscuits, and they have to cook a little bit longer, and then you leave them in the oven. These I left in for about 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. The larger ones are about 25 minutes. Baked at 350. I know the recipe's online on your website.
Mm-hmm.
It's also on my website.
Okay.
I was telling you.
Well, very tasty. Now, how many of these could your brother Michael Phelps eat in one sitting?
Probably all of them. Yeah, exactly.
And what are your plans for the Phelps family for Christmas this year?
So for this year, we're staying in town,
okay.
which is really nice. We'll all be together. My niece and nephew. My niece is 6. Nephew is 4.
Yay.
So it'll be a lot of fun. I think they really embody the spirit of Christmas.
I bet.
And that'll be a big hit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Totally.